Hello people of YouTube, my name is Brad, this is my channel Animate Orange, and welcome back to the 31 Model A build. We're in part 2 now, we've gotten about halfway through the build. So far so good. Let's pick up where we left off last time and finish out this neat little Model A pickup. Right now, I am shaping part 29. The instructions seem to indicate that the engraved or painted side is facing out, which makes sense. However, the part will not fit straight if you fold it that way. If you fold it backwards, however, so that the silver side is facing out, it fits fine. But honestly, I don't think that's what was intended to happen. And I'm not the only one that's noticed this, as I found at least one case on Reddit where somebody else had the same problem. Thank you. I ended up bending over these tabs rather than try to twist them. Parts 35 and 36, if you fold them as indicated, the engraved circle would face forward. I don't feel like that looks correct. In my mind, that circle kind of represents the mirror side. And so I ended up folding the parts so that the circle faced rearward, and I think I may have actually had to swap the parts on the opposite side. And of course, this was a personal choice, so you do it the way that you think it should be. Thank you. Shaping the top of this radiator was rather intimidating, but with some patience, I managed, and I'm quite proud of the result.
Thank you.
Attaching the body to the frame wasn't too bad this time around. The tabs were a bit difficult to get to fold over, but that wasn't that big a deal. We didn't have many blocked slots in this build, but there were a few. Overall, much better than previous build. Twisting the tabs in the curved bed didn't always work, so I folded some of them over instead. I forgot to insert these tabs into the running board on one side. As I twisted one tab, I inadvertently folded the other, but hey, that works. My 3D printed dome shaping tool worked great for the headlights. Alternatively, you could use, say, a small bead instead. Thank you. I had a fun time trying to get the headlight assembly to stay. The fenders were wanting to pull apart and the twisted tabs were not enough to hold, mainly because I couldn't get much of a twist on them. I fiddled around with it for a while and ended up sort of folding the tabs to make it more secure. And that brings us to the end of the 31 Model A build, and it did go quite a bit smoother than the 37. It was just something about that 37 that the paint was too thick. I did not have the issues with the thicker paint on this model. I had a few issues with clogged tabs, which were easy to clear up, just like many of the other colored models I have done. That's not a big deal at all. The fenders came out a lot better on this one, so I'd like to think I've learned some lessons there. I tried to, in part one, give a lot of the detail and show a lot of how I formed those. There were some delicate parts and a couple of things that I kind of changed myself, like these big side mirrors up top. I think I ended up reversing them and kind of folding them differently because I thought it looked better that way. But overall, this was a much easier build, only taking 3 hours and 30 minutes to put together. So still a fair amount of time, quite a bit more than a lot of the older Metal Earth models, but not as long as it took to put together the 37 or 32. So this one went a lot smoother. I'm a little less than thrilled at how the top turned out. The seams are kind of pulling apart more than I'd like, but overall I think this may end up being my favorite, at least of the three that I've built so far. Thought for sure that the 32 was going to be my favorite, and I do like it, but and the Ford pickup is really cool, but this one, I'm really, really liking the look of this one. But there is a full review coming later, if not out already, so I'll leave it at that. Thank you for watching. Thank you to Fascinations for sending this model to build. They sent me three different Ford models to put together and review, and I'm finally done with that. It's taken me quite a while to get around to them because life, busy, universe, everything, whatever. But thank you to Fascinations. Thank you for watching. Thank you to my Patreon supporters for continuing to support this channel. And as always, keep on keeping on.